السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وبعد. All thanks and praise are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and may His peace and blessings be upon His last and final messenger, His family, His companions, and those who follow them until the end of times. Welcome to lesson number 84 of Tafsir al-Jalalain. Alhamdulillah, in our last lesson together, we were able to cover verses 158 through 165 of Surah Al-An'am, which brought us to the end of that noble and beautiful surah. And then we started Surah Al-A'raf, and we reached until the end of verse number 3. And since we only covered the first paragraph of the tafsir on this page, there's nothing wrong with starting with that again today. So I will start off with the first paragraph. قال الإمام جلال الدين السيوطي رحمه الله تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم صاد الله أعلم بمراده بذلك هذا كتاب أنزل إليك خطاب للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فلا يكن في صدرك حرج ضيق منه أن تبلغه مخافة أن تكذب لتنذر متعلق بأنزل أي للإنذار به وذكرى تذكرة للمؤمنين به قل لهم اتبعوا ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم أي القرآن ولا تتبعوا تتخذوا من دونه أي الله أي غيره أولياء تطيعونهم في معصيته تعالى قليلا ما تذكرون بالتاء والياء تتعظون وفيه إدغام التاء في الأصل في الذال وفي قراءة بسكونها وما زائدة لتأكيد القلة. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts off the surah with what is known as الحروف المقطعة, these broken or severed letters. And as we've covered before, the meanings of these letters are a secret from the secrets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one knows what they truly mean. And that is the explanation that Imam As-Suyuti rahimahullah provides as well. So Alif Lam Mim Sad, Allahu A'lamu bi muradihi bi dhalik. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best what He means by them. And one of the objectives of starting a surah and starting a chapter with these broken or severed letters is to highlight the miraculous and inimitable nature of the Quran, and to remind people of the challenge of the Qur'an. That this Qur'an is divine. It is the uncreated, eternal speech of God. And that no human being has the ability to produce anything similar to it in any way, shape, or form. So, Alif Lam Mim Sad, Allahu A'lamu bi muradihi bi dhalik. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best what He means by that. كتاب أنزل إليك فلا يكن في صدرك حرج من لتنذر به وذكرى للمؤمنين. This book has been sent down to you. Let there be no anxiety in your heart because of it, so that you may use it to give warning and to remind the believers. So here Imam As-Suyuti rahimullah says, هذا كتاب أنزل إليك. This is a book that has been revealed to you. This is a book that has been sent down to you. خِطَابٌ لِلنَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمُ. And he clarifies that this is an address to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. فَلَا يَكُنْ فِي صَدْرِكَ حَرَجٌ مِّنْ. So there should be no haraj. There should be no anxiety. There should be no uneasiness. There should be no wavering in your chest. مِنْهُ. From the Qur'an, and he because of it. So let there be no haraj, dhiqun. Let there be no restriction. Let there be no anxiety, no uneasiness in your heart because of it. And here he says the word harajun, which usually means harm, it means dhiqun. Dhiq is something like restrictive. It's the opposite of being vast and open, right? So it's a metaphorical way of describing difficulty and uneasiness and perhaps anxiety. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that let there not be any of that in your chest. Because of what reason? أن تبلغه مخافة أن تكذب. So let there be no anxiety in your heart because of it, right? In terms of conveying it, out of fear of you being called a liar, out of fear of you being rejected, opposed, and belied. Meaning, don't let that fear create any sort of anxiety or uneasiness in your heart. لِتُنذِرَ. Now here he clarifies that لِتُنذِرَ, so that you may use it to give warning. So with it, you may warn. مُتَعَلِّقٌ بِأُنزِلَ is related and connected to the verb أُنزِلَ, meaning this is a book we have revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so that you may use it to give warning. So with it, you may warn. A لِلْإِنذَار بِهِ, meaning we have revealed the book to you so that you may warn with it. وَذِكْرَى, and as a reminder. تَذْكِرَةً, as a reminder. لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ بِ, for those who believe in it. اتَّبِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُم مِّن رَّبِّكُمْ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ قَلِيلًا مَّا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Follow what has been sent down to you from your Lord, and don't take others as guardians besides Him. How seldom are you mindful. So قُلْ لَهُمْ, say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Imam As-Suyuti rahimahullah is clarifying that this is understood, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still addressing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So قُلْ لَهُمْ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to the people of Mecca, اتَّبِعُوا مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُم مِّن رَبِّكُمْ أَيَّ الْقُرْآنَ. Follow what has been revealed to you from your Lord, meaning the Qur'an. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ, and don't take others as guardians besides Him. So here he says تَتَّبِعُوا means تَتَّخِذُوا. So usually the verb اتَّبَعَ يَتَّبِعُوا means to follow. But in this context, Imam As-Suyuti rahimahullah clarifies it means تَتَّخِذُوا, to take. So وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا تَتَّخِذُوا مِن دُونِهِ, don't take besides Him, a Allah, right? Don't take anyone besides Allah, meaning غَيْرَهُ, anyone other than Him, أَوْلِيَا, as guardians, as protectors, as masters. تُطِيعُونَهُمْ فِي مَعْصِيَتِهِ, whom you obey in His disobedience. Meaning, how are you taking them as masters and guardians and protectors? By obeying them in the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَلِيلًا مَا تَذَّكَّرُونَ, how seldom, how rarely you take heed. How seldom, how rarely you are mindful. Now here Imam As-Suyuti rahimahullah, he's using a different qira'ah. تَذَّكَّرُونَ, where one of the ta's of the verb has been assimilated into the dhal, and because of that it gets a shadda. So the original verb is تَذَكَّرَ يَتَذَكَّرُ مِن بَابِ التَّفَعُلِ, verb form number 5. So the actual verb in the present tense is تَتَذَكَّرُونَ. Then some morphological thing comes into play, and one of the ta's gets assimilated into the dhal, and because of that it gets a shadda. So it becomes, instead of تَتَذَكَّرُونَ, it becomes تَذَكَّرُونَ. And he says it can be recited بِالتَّاءِ وَالْيَاءِ, meaning it could be تَذَكَّرُونَ in the second person, or it could be يَذَكَّرُونَ in the third person. And it means تَتَّعِذُونَ, to be mindful, to take heed, to take a lesson and reminder. And then he himself clarifies the morphological rule going on here. وَفِيهِ إِدْغَامُ التَّاءِ فِي الْأَصْلِ فِي الذَّانِ, and in it, the ta is assimilated into the dhan. وَفِي قِرَاءَةٍ, and in another qira'a, بِسُكُونِهَا, but instead of the ashadda being on the dhan, there's a sukoon. But some of the commentators, they mentioned that that qira'a is not mashhura, that qira'a is not well known. وَمَا, يعني قَلِيلًا مَا, this particle ma, زَائِدَةٌ, grammatically speaking, it's something extra, but it is brought for a purpose, and that purpose is لتأكيد القلة, to emphasize the rarity and to emphasize the seldom nature of how often they are mindful. Right? It's to emphasize that fact, that it means that it's very rare that they are mindful. It's very rare that they take heed.
نعم قال رحمه الله وكم خبرية مفعول من قرية أريد أهلها أهلكناها أردنا إهلاكها فجاءها بأسنا عذابنا بياتا ليلا أو هم قائلون نائمون بالظهيرة والقيلولة استراحة نصف النهار وإن لم يكن معها نوم أي مرة جاءها ليلا ومرة نهارا فما كان دعواهم قولهم إذ جاءهم بأسنا إلا أن قالوا إنا كنا ظالمين.
So here in the next verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَمْ مِنْ قَرْيَةٍ أَهْلَكْنَاهَا. How many towns have we destroyed?
فَجَاءَهَا بَأْسُنَا بَيَاتًا أَوْ هُمْ قَائِلُونَ.
Our punishment came to them by night or while they slept in the afternoon. So here Imam Suyuti clarifies that the word كَمْ خَبَرِيَةٌ. Right? It is to inform. It is not istifhamiya. It is not to ask a question. Because this word kam is one of the asma'ul istifham. It is also one of those nouns that is used to ask a question, particularly how much. Right? It's used to ask about quantities. But here he's saying that's not the purpose. Here it is khabariyatun. It is informative. It's relaying information. Maf'ulun. And grammatically speaking, it's playing the role of maf'ul. It's playing the role of a direct object. So,
كَمْ مِنْ قَرْيَةٍ أَهْلَكْنَاهَا.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving this expression that look how many towns and villages we have destroyed. Imagine how many societies we have destroyed.
مِنْ قَرْيَةٍ.
And what he means by قَرْيَة, what he means by village and towns,
أُرِيدَ أَهْلُهَا.
What is intended is its people. Right? How many communities have we destroyed?
أهلكناها.
أردنا إهلاكها, meaning we intended their destruction.
فجاءها بأسنا عذابنا بياتا ليلا.
So its punishment came to them during the night. So بأسنا here means عذابنا. And we've come across this word before, that the word بأسن also means عذابن.
So فجاءها بأسنا عذابنا بياتا.
And he says the word بياتا here means ليلا. So our punishment came to them during the evening.
أَوْهُمْ قَائِلُونَ.
Or it came to them while they were taking their afternoon nap. While they were taking their afternoon rest. So قائلون, he says it means نَائِمُونَ بِالظَّهِرَةً. Sleeping during the afternoon. And then he says
وَالْقَيْلُولَةُ إِسْتِرَاحَةٌ نِصْفَ النَّهَارِ.
That is the rest that is taken during midday.
وَإِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ مَعَهَا نَوْمٌ.
Even if there's no sleep with it. So anytime you take a little bit of a break and you rest in the middle of the day, it is called a qaylula.
A marratan ja'aha laylan wa marratan nahara.
And what this means is that sometimes the punishment came to them during the night and sometimes during the day.
Fama kana da'wahum idh ja'ahum ba'suna illa an qalu inna kunna zalimin.
Their only cry when overwhelmed by our punishment was, we have indeed been wrongdoers. So Allah, here Imam Suyuti says,
فَمَا كَانَ دَعْوَاهُمْ قَوْلَهُمْ.
Right, their call and their statement was nothing, إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا, that when our punishment came to them,
إِلَّا أَنْ قَالُوا,
except that they said,
إِنَّا كُنَّا ظَالِمِينَ,
truly we have been wrongdoers. So their only cry, their only call, their only statement, when our punishment came to them was,
إِنَّا كُنَّا ظَالِمِينَ.
We have truly been wrongdoers.
قال رحمه الله فَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الَّذِينَ أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ أي الْأُمَمَ أن عن إجابتهم الرسل وعملهم فيما بلغهم وَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الْمُرْسَلِينَ عَنِ الْإِبْلَاغِ فَلَنَقُصَّنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ بِعِلْمٍ لَنُخْبِرَنَّهُمْ عَنْ عِلْمٍ بِمَا فَعَلُوا وَمَا كُنَّا غَائِبِينَ عَنْ إِبْلَاغِ الرُّسُلِ وَالْأُمَمِ الْخَالِيَةِ فِيمَا عَمِلُوا وَالْوَزْنُ لِلْأَعْمَالِ أَوْ لِصَحَائِفِهَا بِمِيزَانٍ لَهُ لِسَانٌ وكفتان كما ورد في حديث كائن يومئذ أي يوم السؤال المذكور وهو يوم القيامة الحق العدل صفة الوزن فمن ثقلت موازينه بالحسنات فأولئك هم المفلحون الفائزون ومن خفت موازينه بالسيئات فأولئك الذين خسروا أنفسهم بتصييرها إلى النار بما كانوا بآياتنا يظلمون يجحدون.
In the next verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الَّذِينَ أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الْمُرْسَلِينَ.
We will certainly question those who received messengers, and we will certainly question the messengers themselves.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that we will question those to whom messengers were sent, and we will also question the messengers.
فَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الَّذِينَ أُرْسِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ.
We will surely ask those to whom messengers were sent.
الْأُمَمَ عَنْ عِجَابَتِهِمُ الرُّسُلَ.
Meaning we will ask nations and communities about their response to the messengers. We're going to ask them how they responded to the messengers.
وَعَمَلِهِمْ فِيمَا بَلَغَهُمْ.
And we will ask them about their actions regarding what had reached them. Indeed, did they act upon it or not? Did they respond to the messengers and believe them and act upon the message or not?
وَلَنَسْأَلَنَّ الْمُرْسَلِينَ.
And we will truly ask the messengers as well,
عَنِ الْإِبْلَاغِ,
about conveying the message. The messengers will be asked, يعني, هَلْ بَلَّغْتُمْ, did you convey your message?
فَلَنَقُصَّنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ بِعِلْمٍ وَمَا كُنَّا غَائِبِينَ.
Then we will give them a full account with knowledge, for we were never absent. And with full knowledge, for we were never far from them, we shall tell them what they did.
So, فَلَنَقُصَّنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ بِعِلْمٍ.
Right? We will inform them. نَقُصَّنَّ here he says means
لَنُخْبِرَنَّهُمْ.
We will surely inform them
بِعِلْمٍ,
with knowledge. So
لَنُخْبِرَنَّهُمْ أَنْ عِلْمٍ بِمَا فَعَلُوهُ.
We will truly, we will surely, we will certainly inform them, right, based upon knowledge regarding what they did.
وَمَا كُنَّا غَائِبِينَ.
And we were not absent.
عَنْ إِبْلَاغِ الرُّسُلِ.
Right, we were not absent. عَنْ إِبْلَاغِ الرُّسُلِ, meaning when the messengers conveyed the message.
وَالْأُمَمِ الْخَالِيَةِ فِيمَا عَمِلُوا.
And the past nations regarding what they did. Meaning Allah is fully aware. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fully, fully aware. His knowledge is infinite, limitless, all-encompassing. And He knows that the messengers conveyed the message, and He knows how the communities responded.
وَالْوَزْنُ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْحَقُّ.
On that day, the weighing of deeds will be true and just. The weighing on that day will be just.
فَمَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ.
As for those whose scale will be heavy, they will be successful. Those whose good deeds are heavy on the scales will be the ones who are successful.
So وَالْوَزْنُ,
يعني the weighing. لِلْأَعْمَالِ, right, the weighing of deeds. أو لِصَحَائِفِهَا, or the weighing of their registers. So both of these opinions exist. That on the Day of Judgment, either our deeds themselves are going to be weighed, or the register in which they are recorded is going to be weighed. So الْوَزْنُ, the weighing,
لِلْأَعْمَالِ,
the weighing of deeds. أَوْ لِصَحَائِفِهَا, or the weighing of its registers.
بِمِيزَانٍ,
with a scale.
لَهُ لِسَانٌ,
that has a tongue, meaning can speak.
وَكِفَّتَانِ,
and two sides, two pans.
كَمَا وَرَدَ فِي حَدِيثٍ,
right, as is mentioned in a hadith.
كَائِنٌ,
will happen, will take place.
يَوْمَئِذٍ,
on that day.
A يَوْمَ السُّؤَالِ الْمَذْكُورِ,
right, on the day of the question that was mentioned. Meaning Allah will ask the nations that were sent messengers, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the messengers themselves, meaning on the Day of Judgment.
وَهُوَ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ,
and that is the Day of Judgment.
الْحَقُّ,
يعني الْوَزْنُ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْحَقُّ, will be fair and just and balanced. Al-haqqu al-adlu. He's saying that the word haqq here usually is translated as the truth, but here it means al-adl, is just. And this is the sifa, this is the adjective of al-wazn, meaning the weighing will be just and fair. فَمَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُ. So whoever's balance is heavy, whoever's scale is heavy, بالحسنات, with good deeds, فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ, then they are the ones who are successful. الفائزون, they are the ones who are truly successful.
وَمَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يَظْلِمُونَ.
But those whose scale is light, they have doomed themselves for wrongfully denying our signs. So وَمَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُ, and whoever's scales are light, بِالسَّيِّئَاتِ, right, with sins. فَأُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ, then they are the ones who have lost themselves, they have lost their souls, right? بِتَصْيِيرِهَا إِلَى النَّارِ, by causing them to head and go towards the fire. Why? بِمَا كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يَظْلِمُونَ يَجْحَدُونَ, because they used to reject our signs, our verses, meaning because of their disbelief.
قَالَ رَحِمُهُ اللَّهُ وَلَقَدْ مَكَّنَّاكُمْ يَا بَنِي آدَمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَجَعَلْنَا لَكُمْ فِيهَا مَعَايِشَ بِالْيَاءِ أَسْبَابًا تَعِيشُونَ بِهَا جَمْعُ مَعِيشَةٍ قَلِيلًا مَا لِتَأْكِيدِ الْقِلَّةِ تَشْكُرُونَ عَلَى ذَلِكَ وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَيْ أَبَاكُمْ آدَمَ ثُمَّ صَوَّرْنَاكُمْ أَيْ صَوَّرْنَاهُ وَأَنْتُمْ فِي ظَهْرِي ثُمَّ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ سُجُودَ تَحِيَّةٍ بِالْإِنْحِنَاءِ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى الْجِنِّ كَانَ بَيْنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ لَمْ يَكُمْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ مَكَّنَّاكُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ, we have indeed established you on the earth. وَجَعَلْنَا لَكُمْ فِيهَا مَعَايِشَ, and provided you with a means of livelihood. قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ, yet you seldom give any thanks. So here Imam As-Suyuti rahimahullah says, وَلَقَدْ مَكَّنَّاكُمْ يَا بَنِي آدَمْ, O son of Adam, O human being, O mankind, we have certainly established you, فِي الْأَرْضِ, on the earth. وَجَعَلْنَا لَكُمْ فِيهَا مَعَايِشَ, and we have made sources and means of livelihood for you on it. And he says the word مَعَايِشَ بِالْيَا, right, أَسْبَابًا, right, means تَعِيشُونَ بِهَا, that you live with. And the word مَعَايِش is the plural of مَعِيشَ, جَمْعُ مَعِيشَ, livelihood. قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ, but how seldom, how rarely you express gratitude. And he says the ma here, again it's زائدة, it is extra grammatically speaking, but it's لِتَأْكِيدِ الْقِلَّةِ, to emphasize how rare and how seldom their appreciation and giving of thanks truly is. يعني قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ عَلَى ذَلِكَ, how rarely, how seldom you give thanks upon that.
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَاكُمْ,
and we created you.
ثُمَّ صَوَّرْنَاكُمْ,
then we shaped and fashioned you.
ثُمَّ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمْ,
and then we said to the angels, bow down before Adam.
فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسِ,
and all of them prostrated except for Iblis.
لَمْ يَكُمْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ,
he was not one of those who prostrated. So
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَاكُمْ,
surely, truly, indeed, we created you.
أَيْ أَبَاكُمْ Adam,
meaning we created your father, Adam, the father of all of mankind, the father of humanity.
ثُمَّ صَوَّرْنَاكُمْ,
then we shaped you and fashioned you.
أَيْ صَوَّرْنَاهُ,
we shaped and fashioned Adam عليه السلام.
وَأَنْتُمْ فِي ظَهْرِ,
while you were in his back, yani highlighting that he is the father of all of mankind.
ثُمَّ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ,
and then we said to the angels, أُسْجُدُوا لِآدَمْ, right, prostrate for Adam, bow down before him, prostrate before him.
سُجُودَ تَحِيَّةٍ,
a bowing or prostration of greeting, of honoring and welcome.
بِالْإِنْحِنَاءِ,
by lowering your back a little bit, by bowing down. So the reason why Imam Suyuti mentions this is to highlight is that this was not the sajda of ibadah. This was not like an act of worship. This was not sajda of ta'zim. This was sujood at-tahiyyah. It was a bowing or prostrating of greeting. Bil inhina, by lowering one's back. Fasajadu. So all of the angels did so, illa iblis, except for iblis, abal jinn, right, the father of jinn. Kana bayna al-malaika, who was among the angels at that time because of his unique and special status and his knowledge and his status as a abid, as a worshipper of Allah. Lam yakum min as-sajidin, he was not among those who did sujood. He was not among those who prostrated because of his arrogance and his pride, as we are going to learn. So I'm going to recite the next page from the Mus'haf, followed by the first paragraph of the tafsir.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Qala ma mana'aka alla tasjuda idh amartuk. Qala ana khayrun min khalaqtani min narin wa khalaqtahu min tin. قال فاهبط منها فما يكون لك أن تتكبر فيها فاخرج إنك من الصاغرين قال أنظرني إلى يوم يبعثون قال إنك من المنظرين قال فبما أغويتني لأقعدن لهم صراطك المستقيم ثم لآتينهم من بين أيديهم ومن خلفهم وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم ولا تجد أكثرهم شاكرين قال اخرج منها مذءوما مدحورا لمن تبعك منهم لأملأن جهنم منكم أجمعين ويا آدم اسكن أنت وزوجك الجنة فكلا من حيث شئتما ولا تقربا هذه الشجرة فتكونا من الظالمين فوسوس لهما الشيطان ليبدي لهما ما وري عنهما من سوآتهما وقال ما نهاكما ربكما عن هذه الشجرة إلا أن تكونا ملكين أو تكونا من الخالدين وقاسمهما إني لكما لمن الناصحين فدلاهما بغرور فلما ذاق الشجرة بدت لهما سوآتهما وطفقا يخصفان عليهما من ورق الجنة وناداهما ربهما ألم أنهكما عن تلكما الشجرة وأقل لكما إن الشيطان لكما عدو مبين قال رحمه الله قال تعالى ما منعك ألا زائدة تسجد إذ حين أمرتك قال أنا خير من خلقتني من نار وخلقته من طين قال فاهبط منها أي من الجنة وقيل من السماوات فما يكون ينبغي لك أن تتكبر فيها فاخرج منها إنك من الصاغرين الذليلين قال أنظرني أخرني إلى يوم يبعثون أي الناس.
So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us this episode from the life of Adam alayhi salam. So this is the famous story of the creation of Adam alayhi salam, and then how he was deceived by Satan and as a result was sent down to this earth. So here in verse number 12, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing Iblis, and he says, قَالَ مَا مَنَعَكَ أَلَّا تَسْجُدَ إِذْ أَمَرْتُكَ. Right, Allah said, what prevented you from bowing down when I commanded you? قَالَ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِنْ. He said, I'm better than him. خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَامْ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ طِينَ. You created me from fire and you created him from clay. So here Imam Suyuti rahimahullah says, قَالَ تَعَالَى, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا مَنَعَكَ أَلَّا زَائِدَةٌ تَسْجُدْ إِذْ حِينَ أَمَرْتُكَ. What stopped you? What prevented you from prostrating when I commanded you to do so? And here he says that Allah is za'ida. Again, grammatically speaking, it's za'ida, but it's meant for a purpose of emphasis. And he says, id, the particle id means hina, when. What stopped you, what prevented you from prostrating when I told you to do so, when I commanded you to do so? قَالَ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِنْ Iblis responded by saying, I'm better than him. خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارٍ You created me from fire. وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ طِينٍ And you created him from clay. And according to his standards, he believed that fire was better than clay. قَالْ فَهْبِطْ مِنْهَا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, get down from here. Leave from here. فَمَا يَكُونُ لَكَ أَن تَتَكَبَّرَ فِيهَا It is not for you to be arrogant here. This is no place for your arrogance. فَخْرُجْ إِنَّكَ مِنَ الصَّاغِرِينَ Get out. You are contemptible. You are truly one of the disgraced. So قال, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَهْبِطْ مِنْهَا Leave from here. Get down from here. أي من الجنة Right, leave from paradise. وَقِيلْ And it is said, مِنَ السَّمَاوَاتِ From the heavens. فَمَا يَكُونُ يَنْبَغِي It is not appropriate, لَكَ for you, أَن تَتَكَبَّرَ فِيهَا To be arrogant in it. Right, this is no place for your arrogance. It is not for you to be arrogant here. فَخْرُجْ مِنْهَا So get out, leave from here. إِنَّكَ مِنَ الصَّاغِرِينَ Truly, you are among the humiliated, the disgraced, الذليلين, the disgraced. قَالَ أَنْظِرْنِي إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ So he said, then delay my end until the day of resurrection. Grant me time, grant me respite until the day people are raised from the dead. So قَالَ إِبْلِيسًا أَنْظِرْنِي Right, give me some time, أَخِرْنِي Give me some time, delay my time. إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ Until the day they are resurrected, أي الناس. Until the day mankind is resurrected. قَالَ رَحِمُهُ اللَّهِ قَالَ إِنَّكَ مِنَ الْمُنْظَرِينَ وَفِي آيَةٍ أُخْرَى إِلَى يَوْمِ الْوَقْتِ الْمَعْلُومِ أي وقت النفخة الأولى. قَالَ فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي أي بِإِغْوَائِكَ لِي وَالْبَاءُ لِلْقَسْمِ وَجَوَابُهُ لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ أي لِبَنِي آدَمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ أي عَلَى الطَّرِيقِ الْمُوصِلِ إِلَيْكَ ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ أي من كل جهة فأمنعهم عن سلوكي قال ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما وَلَا يَسْتَطِيعُ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ لِأَلَّا يَحُولَ بَيْنَ الْعَبْدِ وَبَيْنَ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ مُؤْمِنِينَ So we're continuing now with this conversation that took place between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Iblis. So he says, قَالَ إِنَّكَ مِنَ الْمُنْظَرِينَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Iblis, you have been given respite. You are delayed. You have been given this delay until the appointed day. So قال, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّكَ مِنَ الْمُنْظَرِينَ You are among those who have been delayed. You are among those who have been given respite. وَفِي آيَةٍ أُخْرَى In another verse, it says, إِلَى يَوْمِ الْوَقْتِ الْمَعْلُومِ Until the known time. Right? Until the day of the known time, meaning the time of the first sounding of the trumpet. Right? قال, then he says, Iblis says, قال, فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأَقْعُدَنَّ لَهُمْ صِرَاطَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ He said, because you have put me in the wrong. Right? Because you have left me to go astray, I will lie in wait for them all on your straight path. I will lie in ambush for them on your straight path. Look at, you know, this is part of the disgraced nature of shaitan. Like it's like he's almost blaming Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي He said, because you let me go astray. بِإِغْوَائِكَ لِي By you allowing me to go astray. وَالْبَاءُ لِلْقَسَمِ And he says the ba here is for an oath. Like he's swearing. وَجَوَابُهُ And the response of this oath is لَأَقْعُودَنَّ لَهُمْ I will sit waiting for them. I will lie in wait for them. Meaning, I will
lie in ambush for them. A, li bani Adam, for mankind, for all of humanity, for the children of Adam, صراطك المستقيم, on your straight path. A, على الطريق الموصلي إليك, meaning on the path that reaches you, or that leads towards you. So Shaytan is taking this oath that that's what he's going to do. He's going to lie in wait and lie in ambush in order to attack anyone who is trying to travel the path towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he says, ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. I will come at them from their front and their back, from their right and their left, and you will find that most of them are ungrateful. I will approach them from their front, their back, their right, and their left, and then you will find most of them ungrateful. So here Imam al-Suyuti says, ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ. Then I will surely come to them, I will surely approach them, from in front of them, behind them, وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ, from their right, وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ, from their left, أَيْمِنْ كُلِّ جِهَةٍ, meaning from all directions, from all sides. I'm going to attack this human being every single way possible. فَأَمْنَعُهُمْ عَنْ سُلُوكِ. And I will stop and prevent them from traveling your straight path. قَالَ ابْنُ عَبَّاسِ ابْنُ عَبَّاسِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمَ said, وَلَا يَسْتَطِيعُ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ. And he will not be able to come from above. لِأَلَّا يَحُولَ بَيْنَ الْعَبْدِ وَبَيْنَ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. So that he cannot be a barrier between a servant and the mercy of God. وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. And you will find most of them to be ungrateful. مؤمنين. يعني you will not find most of them grateful, meaning you will not find most of them to be believers. And that is why Shaytan is our open, sworn enemy. He has this hatred for us, this enmity towards us. And he's trying his best to lead as many of us astray as possible. قال رحمه الله قال اخرج منها مذؤوما بالهمز معيبا أو ممقوتا مدحورا مبعدا عن الرحمة لمن تبعك منهم من الناس واللام للابتداء أو موطئة للقسم وهو لأملأن جهنم منكم أجمعين أي منك بذريتك ومن الناس وفيه تغليب الحاضر على الغائب وفي الجملة معنى جزاء من الشرطية أي من تبعك أعذبه وقال يا آدم أسكن أنت تأكيد للضمير في أسكن ليعطف عليه وزوجك حواء بالمد الجنة فكلا من حيث شئتما ولا تقربا هذه الشجرة بالأكل منها وهي الحنطة فتكونا من الظالمين. Right. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to him, قال اخرج منها مذؤوما مدحورا. Allah said, get out of paradise. You are disgraced and rejected. You are disgraced and banished. لمن تبعك منهم. And لأملأن جهنم منكم أجمعين. I swear, I shall fill hell with you and all who follow you. I will certainly fill up hell with you and your followers all together. So قال, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أخرج منها. Get out of here. Leave from here. Leave from paradise. مذؤوماً. Disgraced. Right? He says the word مذؤوماً بالهمزي. Right? There's a hamza here on the right. مذؤوماً. معيباً. معيباً like defective. أو ممقوتاً. Humiliated, disgraced. مدحوراً. Rejected. مبعداً. Distance from mercy. لمن تبعك منهم. Right, truly whoever among them follows you, min al-nas, from mankind. And he says, وَاللَّامُ لِلْإِبْتِدَى, meaning the lam can be ibtida, yani a dakhilatun ala al-mubtada, that it is entered or it has come upon the mubtada, and that is the man al-shartiyya, which serves as the mubtada. So that would be the mubtada, and the khabr would be لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. Or he says, مَوْطِئَةٌ لِلْقَسْمِ, a دالة على قسم مقدر. It's indicating towards a understood oath, right? والتقدير والله,
And what it means is, by Allah, لَمَنْ تَبِعَكَ. That by Allah, whoever among them follows you, then I will definitely fill fire, the hellfire, with you and them. All of you. Right? So he says, لَمَنْ تَبِعَكَ مِنْهُمْ مِنَ النَّاسِ. And he says, the lam here, لِلْإِبْتِدَى. يعني it is to highlight that the man here is مُبْتَدَى. أَوْ مَوْطِئَةٌ لِلْقَسَمْ. Or it's indicating towards a oath that is understood. وَهُوَ لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. Right. I will certainly fill hell with all of you. أي مِنْكَ بِذُرِّيَّتِكَ وَمِنَ النَّاسِ. Meaning, I will fill hellfire with you and your family and mankind. وَفِيهِ تَغْلِيبُ الْحَاضِرِ عَلَى الْغَائِمِ. And in saying, لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكُمْ, right, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the hadir, those who are present, over those who are absent. وَفِي الْجُمْلَةِ مَعْنَى جَزَى. Right, in this jumla itself, لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ has the meaning of the jaza of the shart. Yani the response of the conditional statement, مَنْ أَشْرَطِيَ أَيْ مَنْ تَبِعَكَ أُعَذِّبْهُ. Meaning, whoever follows you, I will punish them. وَقَالْ يا آدم اسكن أنت وزوجك الجنة فكلا من حيث شئتما ولا تقربا هذه الشجرة فتكونا من الظالمين. O Adam, live with your wife in paradise and eat from wherever you please, but don't approach this tree or else you will be among the wrongdoers. Meaning, but you and your wife Adam live in paradise, both of you eat whatever you like, but don't go near this tree, or you will become wrongdoers. Right. So here, Imam As-Suyuti rahimahullah says, وَقَالْ, meaning, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا Adam, O Adam alayhi salam, أُسْكُنْ أَنْتَ وَزَوْجُكَ الْجَنَّةِ. You and your wife live in paradise, reside in paradise. So أُسْكُنْ أَنْتَ. He says the dhamir, this pronoun anta, ta'kidun, is emphasis لِلْضَمِيرِ فِي أُسْكُن, for the pronoun that is found in أُسْكُن, because أُسْكُن is the command, and what's understood in the command is anta already. Right? It's a hidden pronoun, it's understood. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions anta again for emphasis لِيُعْتَفَ عَلَيْهِ, so that this can, you can bring this ma'tuf, which is وَزَوْجُكَ. يعني يَا آدَمْ أُسْكُنْ أَنْتَ وَزَوْجُكَ. The O Adam, you and your wife, حَوَّى بِالْمَدْ, live in Jannah. فَكُلَا مِنْ حَيْثُ شِئْتُمَا. And both of you eat from wherever you like. وَلَا تَقْرَبَ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةَ بِالْأَكْلِ مِنْهَا. But don't come close to this tree by eating from it. وَهِيَ الْحِنْطَى. And according to one explanation and one interpretation, it's wheat. فَتَكُونَا مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Because then both of you will be among the wrongdoers. قَالَ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ فَوَسْوَسَ لَهُمَ الشَّيْطَانِ إِبْلِيسِ لِيُبْدِيَ يُظْهِرَ لَهُمَا مَا وُورِيَ فُعِلَ مِنَ الْمُوَارَاتِ عَنْهُمَا مِنْ سَوْآتِهِمَا وَقَالَ مَا نَهَاكُمَا رَبُّكُمَا عَنْ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةِ إِلَّا كَرَاهَةَ أَنْ تَكُونَا مَلَكَيْنِ وَقُرِئَ بِكَسْرِ اللَّامِ أَوْ تَكُونَا مِنَ الْخَالِدِينَ. أي وذلك لازم عن الأكل منها كما في آية أخرى هل أدلك على شجرة الخلد وملك لا يبلى وقاسمهما أي أقسم لهما بالله إني لكما لمن الناصحين في ذلك. So we're continuing now with this story between Adam عليه السلام and Shaytan, and how Shaytan deceived and tricked and fooled Adam عليه السلام. فَوَسْوَسَ لَهُمَ الشَّيْطَانِ. Satan whispered to them. Right? He tempted them. لِيُبْدِيَ لَهُمَا مَا وُورِيَ عَنْهُمَا مِنْ سَوْآتِهِمَا. So as to expose their nakedness which had been hidden from them. Then Satan whispered to them, tempted them, in order to expose what was hidden of their nakedness. وَقَالَ مَا نَهَاكُمَا رَبُّكُمَا عَنْ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةِ إِلَّا أَنْ تَكُونَا مَلَكَيْنِ أَوْ تَكُونَا مِنَ الْخَالِدِينَ. And he said, your Lord only forbade you this tree to prevent you becoming angels or immortals. Your Lord has forbidden this tree to you only to prevent you from becoming angels or immortals. So this again is from the deception of Shaytan, his trickery and his enmity towards mankind. فَوَسْوَسَ لَهُمَ الشَّيْطَانِ Iblis. Shaytan whispered to them. Shaytan tempted them. And who is Shaytan? Iblis. لِيُبْدِيَ يُظْهِرَ Right, to expose, to show. لَهُمَا For both of them. مَا وُورِيَ عَنْهُمَا مِنْ سَوْآتِمَا What had been covered from their awrah. What had been covered from their nakedness. So, لِيُبْدِيَ يُظْهِرَ To expose, to show. مَا وُورِيَ He's saying the word وُورِيَ here is on the pattern فُوْعِلَ Meaning it's majhul, it's in the passive voice. مِنَ الْمُوَارَاتِ From the verb wara yuwari. It comes from the verb wara yuwari, which is min bab al-mufa'ala. So wuriya is fu'ila. Right? It's the passive voice. Anhuma, ma wuriya anhuma, what had been hidden for them, concealed for them, min so'atihima, from their nakedness. So shaytan whispered to them in order to expose what was hidden of their nakedness. وقال, and he said, مَا نَهَاكُمَا رَبُّكُمَا عَنْ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةِ That your Lord did not forbid you from this tree إِلَّا كَرَاهَا Except for dislike أَنْ تَكُونَا مَلَكَيْنَ Right, your Lord did not forbid you from this tree right, except to prevent you from becoming مَلَكَيْنِ Angels وَقُرِئَ بِكَسْرِ اللَّهِ Meaning مَلِكَيْنِ Kings أَوْ تَكُونَا مِنَ الْخَالِدِينَ Or to be among those who will live for eternity, immortals. A, وَذَٰلِكَ لَازِمٌ عَنِ الْأَكْلِ مِنْهَا Meaning, and if you eat from it, that's what's going to happen. That if you eat from this tree, you'll become angels or kings or immortals. كَمَا فِي آيَةٍ أُخْرَى As we find in the verse that's mentioned in Surah Taha, where Iblis said to them, هَلْ أَدُلُّكَ عَلَى شَجَرَةِ الْخُلْدِ وَمُلْكٍ لَا يَبْلَى right, Shall I direct you and point you towards the tree of eternity and kingship that will never come to an end? وَقَاسَمَهُمَا إِنِّي لَكُمَا لَمِنَ النَّاصِحِينَ And he swore to them, I am giving you sincere advice. I am truly your sincere advisor. Right? وَقَاسَمَهُمَا He swore to them, أَقْسَمَ لَهُمَا بِاللَّهِ He swore to them by Allah, إِنِّي لَكُمَا لَمِنَ النَّاصِحِينَ Truly, for both of you, I am among the sincere advisors. فِذَلِك And what I'm telling you right now, I'm telling you as a sincere advisor. I'm giving you sincere advice. Again, this is the deception, the trickery, the enmity of Shaytan. فَدَلَّاهُمَا بِغُرُورٍ He lured them with lies. He brought about their fall through deception. فَلَمَّا ذَاقَ الشَّجَرَةَ بَدَتْ لَهُمَا سَوْآتُهُمَا وَطَفِقَا يَخْسِفَانِ عَلَيْهِمَا مِنْ وَرَقِ الْجَنَّةِ وَنَادَاهُمَا رَبُّهُمَا أَلَمْ أَنْهَكُمَا عَنْ تِلْكُمَا الشَّجَرَةِ وَأَقُلْ لَكُمَا إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمَا عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ Right, he brought about their fall through deception, and when they tasted the tree, their nakedness was exposed to them, prompting them to cover themselves with leaves from paradise. Then their Lord called out to them, Did I not forbid you from that tree? And did I not tell you that Satan is your sworn enemy? So here Imam Suyuti says, فَدَلَّاهُمَا حَطَّهُمَا عَنْ مَنْزِلَتِهِمَا بِغُرُورٍ مِّنْهُ فَدَلَّاهُمَا حَطَّهُمَا عَنْ مَنْزِلَتِهِمَا Right, he caused them to fall from their station. So he brought about their fall. Right, he caused them to fall, right, from their manzila, from their station in paradise, bighururin, through deception, through lies, minhu, from him. فَلَمَّا ذَاقَ الشَّجَرَةَ And as soon as they tasted the tree, أَكَلَا مِنْهَا As soon as they ate from it, بَدَتْ لَهُمَا سَوْآتُهُمَا Their nakedness became exposed. Right, their nakedness became exposed. ظهر لكل منهما قبله وقبل الآخر ودبره أي ظهر لكل منهما قبله meaning their front private part and the private part of the other
and their backsides became exposed. وَسُمِّيَ كُلٌّ مِّنْهَا سَوْءَةٌ لِأَنَّ انْكِشَافَهُ يَسُوءُ صَاحِبَهُ. And, you know, the backside and the front side have been called سَوْءَ because their exposure causes harm to the person.
وَطَفِقَا يَخْصِفَانِ وَأَخَذَا يُلْزِقَانِ.
And then they immediately started covering themselves عليهما من ورق الجنة, from the leaves of paradise, ليستترا به, so that they can cover themselves with it. You know, they can cover themselves with their leaves.
وناداهما ربهما,
and their Lord called out to them,
ألم أنهكما عن تلكما الشجرة,
did I not forbid you from that tree? Did I not forbid you from that tree?
وأقول لكما,
and didn't I say to you,
إن الشيطان لكما عدو مبين,
that truly Satan is your open sworn enemy, بين العداوة, that his enmity is open and clear,
استفهام تقرير.
Right, this is a question of affirmation. It's a rhetorical question to affirm.
قال ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين.
They replied, our Lord, we have wronged ourselves. If you don't forgive us and have mercy on us, we will certainly be among those who are lost.
قَالَ, they both said,
and Adam and his wife Hawa both said, رَبَّنَا, O our Lord,
ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا,
we have wronged ourselves, بِمَعْصِيَتِنَا, through our mistake.
وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا,
and if you don't forgive us, وَتَرْحَمْنَا, and have mercy upon us,
لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ,
then we will definitely be among the losers. So we are just about out of time, and this is a good place for us to stop because we reached the end of the page. Alhamdulillah, we reached till the end of verse number 23. So inshallah, in our next lesson, we will pick right up with verse number 24. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept this effort of ours, to place it on our scale of good deeds on the Day of Judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this a means of strengthening our relationship with the Qur'an. May He make it a means of increasing our understanding of the Qur'an. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give all of us the tawfiq, the ability to recite the Qur'an, understand it, and act upon it. And we ask Allah to make the Qur'an a proof for us and not a proof against us. Wa sallallahumma ala nabiyyina mawlana Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. جزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.